few months ago, the electric car company known as Faraday Future had a groundbreaking ceremony for its $1 billion manufacturing facility located outside Las Vegas. Now, if you've been subscribed for a while, you would know that during CES, I made a video talking about some stuff that Faraday Future revealed at the event, and that Faraday Future was a company that aimed to take on Tesla, but they don't have any vehicles on the market at this point in time. Although this is true, what we have seen from them so far is still pretty good. But back to the $1 billion factory news. At that point, Faraday Future's business strategy was still a little unclear, and it still kind of is right now. The company had hired hundreds of people into its Southern California headquarters, including BMW designer Richard Kim and Tesla engineer Nick Samson, and their work is also being funded by China's Li Eco Media conglomerate, which is also working with Aston Martin. But beyond a vague notion that Faraday wants to make autonomous vehicles and use a flexible chassis that can support multiple vehicle types, there's not much to go on. The company has suggested that it may operate under some sort of subscription model where users could call up different kinds of self-driving EVs depending on their needs. It was just 5 months ago that Faraday Future was claiming that it was finally restarting construction of its proposed factory in North Las Vegas, almost 10 months after construction was first halted amid the company's ongoing financial woes. Now it looks like that factory might never be built, as Faraday Future is reportedly looking into pursuing less ambitious or cheaper options. The news, first reported by the Nevada Independent, broke less than a week after it was reported that a Chinese court froze $182 million in assets of Jia Yiting, founder of tech conglomerate Li Eco and a major investor in Faraday Future. At the time, the company claimed that Jia's money woes wouldn't affect production of the FF91, the startup's first production model slated for a 2018 release date. We have decided to put a hold on our factory at the Apex site in North Las Vegas. We remain committed to the Apex site in Las Vegas for long-term vehicle manufacturing. Stefan Kurz, who has been Faraday Future's chief financial officer for the past 4 months, said in a statement to The Independent, "We at Faraday Future are significantly shifting our business strategy to position the company as the leader in usership personal mobility, a vehicle usage model that reimagines the way users access mobility. As a result of this shift in direction, we are in the final stages of confirming a new manufacturing facility that presents a faster path to start of production and aligns with future strategic options." I am not surprised that this happened though. Faraday Future is still technically a baby company if compared to the likes of Tesla, so errors here and there aren't going to be anything new. I actually hope that the future of the company is successful, because it would be really interesting to see an actual working model of the FF91 vehicle out in the public. And this is where I end today's video. If you like the video, learned anything new, or want more, feel free to smash that like button, share this video with your friends, and subscribe for cool new videos every single week. Thanks for watching, and if you want to suggest a future video, you can easily do so by leaving a comment down below. Once again guys, thanks for watching, and I will be seeing you in the next video.